What's up, guys? So day zero, I'm here at the convention in St. Charles, quote unquote St. Louis, and it's raining like crazy right now. So today is day zero. I'm sharing the room with Tom and Keith, and I went to set up today. I had a long day. It was pretty. I wasted a lot of time in traffic today. There's two accidents, so I didn't get to St. Louis until like 3 p.m. And I feel pretty tired right now. I finished setting up, I got to the convention. I had to go pick up my friend Tom. And then when I came back, I went back to the convention to set up. That's Tom right here. And I finished setting up around 7 p.m. Then I was hungry. I was planning on going to the gym, but it didn't happen that way. So I went to get something to eat and bought some supply for tomorrow. And that's it. I'm excited for tomorrow. I was talking to someone today while I was setting up. They say that the numbers, according to what they were talking about, like they're expecting 20,000 attendees. That's what they said. So we'll see. I don't know how you guys feel, but if that's the case, then it'll be the biggest one, biggest show I've seen, you know, I've done so far. So we'll see tomorrow. Everybody's working right now. I can't show you guys what they're doing because, you know, they might sue me, you know. So anyway, that's
I
it for
get sued too.
Anyway, so that's it for right now. I'll see you guys later. Hi. So I found the gym here at the hotel. Super tiny. It looks big at first when I came in, but I realized that was just the mirror. So probably gonna get back to the room and finish up some work. Prepping and then come back down and do some exercise with Tom maybe. Hey, good morning guys. So today is day one. It's about 8 o'clock right now. Tom and Keith went down there to get some breakfast. I just finished getting ready and I'm about to join them down there. So I'll see you guys in a bit. I'm gonna go over there and finish resetting up really quick the frames and all, and then the show starts at 9:30. So I can't wait. Alright guys, so day one, I'm back. I reset up the table. I'm about to head back and pick up Tom and Keith, and we'll get back here. So it's about 9 o'clock. We got about 30 minutes. So I'll be right back, guys. So this time around, I got inspired by my friend again, you know, Chris, and he's doing like live drawing out here in front of the table. See if I will attract people. So I figured I'd try this, you know. So I bought a little canvas yesterday. I bought an easel, a tall easel. Yeah, the show is about to start and I think I'll start drawing on it right now. And what I'm doing today is Captain America with the hammer. And it's gonna be all in black ink. Yeah, we'll see how it goes, you know. Hopefully it gets people to come over. Get people curious to see what I'm doing. So yeah. So and it also gets me to practice on standing up, drawing standing up, because I've never really done it. I'm not really good at that. So yeah, we'll see how it goes, you know.
It's Cap with the hammer.
Yeah, yes. Cap with the hammer.
Oh my gosh, that was my favorite scene in the movie.
Oh yeah.
When I had just had that moment where the hammer was lifting up, I knew it. And I went, oh my gosh.
You already knew it was Cap?
I knew it.
Oh,
I knew
wow.
It. Yeah, I knew it. I was like, oh my god, is Cap going to get the hammer? Is Cap going to get the hammer?
Oh,
yeah,
right,
yeah.
Right.
Yeah, a lot of people that I've talked to didn't like, especially like diehard, like those who aren't diehard
they
comic
fans. They didn't like
fans.
It?
No, they just didn't know.
Oh, they didn't know?
They just thought the hammer was coming to Thor, but as soon as it started lifting, I went, Cap's going to get
the hammer. Because it was so unexpected.
It was goosebumps.
Yeah, it was unexpected. You know, for people, so yeah.
But it was one of those moments where I went just, oh please,
right?
And then boom, goosebumps.
And that was the case.
That was my favorite moment.
Yeah.
What? Yeah, an orgasm.
Oh, I just love when Captain picked up the hand.
Yeah, that's what you're
talking about. Oh, you had an orgasm. Oh,
nerd.
Oh, nerdgasm. Oh, okay. Yes. Yeah. Yes, I did. Yeah. I did. And then just when he hit him up, and then when he just zapped the lightning. That's my favorite scene.
Isn't it funny that he handled the hammer better than Thor ever did? Isn't it funny? I thought it was funny.
I won't go that far.
Well, yeah, in a way, as far as calling the lightning, because you've never seen Thor calling the lightning as much Captain.
Well, in a Thor movie.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
This is my favorite part of the movie, hands down.
And I love it. Cap catches the big one that Thor catches the smaller one. No, give me
the big one.
You get the little one.
Yeah, you get the little one.
Give me the big one. You get the little one.
No, their dynamic chemistry at the end, the three of them.
Yeah.
The three main ones there was just so awesome.
Yeah.
I mean, the three of them versus Thanos there was the best part.
That was a good fight.
Oh, yeah. It was amazing. Yeah. When Thor zapped Iron Man, he just had all that. Yeah. But then Thanos just deflected all.
Yeah,
I mean, that was a massive attack coming from Iron Man.
Yeah.
Just their team up.
Yeah.
What was fantastic is when Cap threw the shield, and then he threw the hammer to hit the shield,
yeah,
to have it come back.
Back
and
yeah.
Oh, it was just like, oh my gosh. It's just amazing. So good.
Yeah.
I'll let you get back to work.
Oh, yeah, no problem. Hey, man, I got 2 days. All right, so I haven't updated in a while. It's almost 2 o'clock, so 1:45, and it's been a slow day. I've been working on my live drawing this whole time. Go for it. And what was I saying? Yeah, I've been working on my live drawing this whole time on the Captain America. I like the way it came out. I like it. It definitely made me more confident driving in front of people. Drawing in front of people. And they had a problem earlier when right before we opened, they didn't have any AC going. And it was the same problem yesterday when we were setting up. So I went to talk to the security and they said they let management know. And now we got some AC, so it's good. It's good. But yeah, I can't imagine if we didn't have any AC. Man, it would have been horrible. But other than that, it's just slow, like I said, you know, it's just slow. Haven't even made table yet. I'm close to making, but it's just slow. And it's because of the rainstorm. But now I went to the bathroom just not long ago, and I saw that the sun came back. So hopefully it'll bring people out again. Today we have the show until us. We have the show until 7 p.m. So we got plenty of time. You know, I got plenty of time to make that money back. We'll see. Other than that, what else? Can't think of anything else going on right now at this show. There's a lot more guests, special guests, you know, than at the last MoneyCon. And a lot more artists as well, a lot more vendors. It's definitely a bigger crowd. And so earlier they said I was expecting, well, they posted officially that, hello there, about 20,000 people, but it doesn't seem like it right now.
Excitement going on out there. We're missing it.
Right? So, but then again, it might be because of the storm. So storm is over. Hopefully there'll be more people coming. So we'll see how it goes, you know. Other than that, that's also, So it's about 3:40 right now, and it's been super slow. I think I'm at 1:10 right now. I haven't even made the table back. Very close again, but not yet. It's very sunny outside right now. They opened the double doors on the corner that I was in. And so people coming from this way, easier, you know. And I don't know, I'm getting tired. It's kind of slow. We have until 7 today. And hopefully it'll pick up, you know how it is. There's always like last minute, you know, sales. So we'll see how it goes, you know. But I'm just tired, I'm feeling tired. I want to get some Chinese food. They had a little stand outside the room, and they were selling Chinese food, so I just bought some food. And hello there, how you doing, sir? Doing good. Feel free to look, let me know if you have any questions. Tonight I'm gonna try to, what am I talking about? I know tonight we're gonna go eat, Ramel wanna go eat, so we're gonna see where he wants to go eat. I think a few other artists around here wants to go out and eat. So it's a good opportunity to make some connection and get to know others. You know. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. I know I was talking to Keith earlier, and he said that they were doing okay also. You know. But, But for them, it's good. You know, it's good money because, you know, they're special guests. So they don't have to worry about anything else. So that's good for them. But for me, I'm hoping I make my table back today at the very least. Because right now, it's super dead. We're not dead. There's a lot of people, but it's just... I haven't made any, I haven't saw any friend yet today. Then again, it's a comic convention. Usually at comic convention, you know, it's slower, you know, to move the friend. So it's okay. No complaint. No complaint. I'm still worried about updating the Smash Bros. Because of the new characters, you know, but I'd rather wait for the last reveal, the fourth one, once all four characters are revealed, then that will update the Smash Bros. That way it gives me enough time to just kind of like push out the last of my inventory for it. So yeah. Anyway guys, see you guys in a bit. Kind of tired. So I'm literally checked out right now. I've just been walking around for the past 45 minutes. There's nothing going on. Everybody was gone an hour ago. I am super tired. And I'm just gonna go out and eat with Ramel. See where these guys wanna go, you know? I'm super tired. It's totally dead. Still haven't made my table back, so very disappointed. Very, very disappointed. But we'll see what tomorrow, you know, holds for us. They say tomorrow's gonna be pretty. And I hope so, because right now, like outside, it's just clear. Like, the sky is clear, and it's just sunny, and it's super hot. It's supposed to be like 90 out there. So, I don't know, it's whatever. We'll see what tomorrow, we'll see how it is tomorrow. I just hope that, I don't know, we'll see what happens. I hope it's better. So, I'll see you guys later. Bring my stuff back in the car, and I'm probably gonna head there early today, so I have enough time to walk around. So I'll see you guys over there. So day two, going around in the morning, looking around at the tables since I didn't get a chance to. This is my friend's Ramel's booth. Yesterday he killed it. He did really good compared to the last show that we had at Quad Cities, the MightyCon also in Quad Cities. And yeah, yesterday we were talking about it, and he did really good. And the reason is, so the reason he did really good yesterday is because last time he was at the show in Quad Cities, he didn't have all this set up, like the display, you know. And the display at the convention is everything. If you guys can make it flashy, then people will come and, you know, look at your table, and they'll be more likely to buy stuff, you know. So yeah, definitely, you know, make sure you guys work on your display. Last time he only had a table only, and he only had all his stuff laying down on the table, so he didn't have any like of the grid and all that. So make sure you guys if you get the chance, you know, spend a little bit extra on your display, you know, just to make it flashy, and it will help you. It'll go a long way, trust me.
Put a Photoshop filter on that, like a Gaussian blur.
Yeah.
And like speed, or what's it called, like perspective, like speed perspective,
oh,
and
yeah,
it
yeah.
will blur it. Okay. So you can't see what you've drawn.
Yeah, but at least you got
the
background,
you'll
the shape,
have a
yeah.
background,
oh, that's smart.
It makes sense, and then you can draw over that.
Oh, or, man, that's smart.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, I know exactly
that
what you mean.
That is how you fill in
yeah.
the shit. It's like fill in the stuff that you yeah, can't yeah, quite yeah. like write.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know. I do it
no,
that makes sense, backwards.
Though.
I do all my books totally opposite from what they originally trained. Because I don't hire writers or anything. I write my own.
Yeah.
And then just do all the lettering in my own style.
Right. But it totally makes sense though, like yeah. just like when you have the idea, you just draw it. Even
right.
though you might not use it, you just keep it on the side and then just put it in the bag. That's a good idea.
I got a whole folder at
yeah.
my house that's got
yeah.
hundreds and hundreds of drawings like on my
right.
computer that I put into the folder if I think I might use it one day.
Right, right. Yeah, just whether it's just background or character. Dude, that's smart. Oh man, I never thought about
use
that.
Use the same panel, double it, duplicate
yeah.
it, flip it. Do something
yeah,
different.
Yeah, that little blur
it.
Thing, like you said to
yeah,
you.
Yeah, man. I mean, it's totally. That's the beautiful thing about it is that once
yeah.
you find out how to do it, you probably have an endless catalog of art. Right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's just right now it's stained with the IP that we don't own.
Right, right.
But if you turn it into your own,
that's
like
exactly
dragon,
yeah. That's what I want to do.
It's not exactly the dragon from that.
Exactly. Right? Yeah, yeah. It's not exactly the same.
Oh.
Yeah,
and I have a picture of Genji.
Yeah, yeah.
I have a print that I'm using.
Right,
it's
right.
going to be a dragon in my comic book because I just drew the dragon coming out of the sword. But
right.
I mean, eventually I'm going to take this print and throw it away. And then
yeah,
I'll
yeah.
just use the dragon that I made, you know?
Yeah, no, that
but
makes
I don't
sense.
Know if that's the right way to do it, but...
I mean, it's not exactly the same. You might have picked a few part or feature from it, but I guess it's not the same, right? So it doesn't technically, you know...
I mean, yeah.
Yeah. That's some good tips, man. Yeah.
I mean, that just gets you motivation. When you have more
yeah,
stuff...
Yeah.
Something to flip through, you're finally
yeah,
like,
yeah. And it's less stressful later to kind of
yeah.
wow.
You don't feel as overwhelmed.
Nice.
It's easier on yourself.
Damn, that's true. That's some good tips.
Alright, man.
Yeah.
I'm gonna head back over.
Alright, man. I see you around, man. Have a good day.
Yeah.
Yep. Alright, take 7. So, it's a little slow right now, but it's okay. I figure I was talking to my neighbor and they said that it's probably going to be slower than yesterday, so it's fine, it's whatever, you know. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw, right now I'm doing a drawing for Carla Perez, which is the actress for Rita Repulsa and Mighty Morphin Power Ranger, the originals. So I'm trying to finish this, probably the next 30 minutes, and I'm going to walk over there and give it to her. Hopefully get a nice picture as well with her, so we'll see. But yeah, pretty excited. Hello there, how you doing? Yeah. And yeah, I hope the... Say again?
How much is that?
Everything is $10. Yeah, unless there's a price on it, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, you know, it looks like this right now. You guys can tell. But yeah, hopefully finish it soon and bring it to her and see if she likes it, you know. And yeah, that's it. That's the plan for today. I don't have anything much. I'm not expecting too much Muxel. I'm close to making my table back, which kind of sucks right now, but hey, it's whatever. Hopefully I made that back in a little bit and some extra, because I don't have much hope right now for the rest of the day. So that's about it, you know. So anyway, I'm gonna get back to this. I'll see you guys later. Got some energy drink for my buddy.
Thank you.
Who sells excess beer. I see him at every show. He brought me a big case this time. So that's cool, you know. I need some energy anyway for tonight. I got a 10-hour drive, so hopefully it's gonna help, you know. I'm gonna go easy on it, but yeah, at least I got something. So I just got back from seeing Carla Perez. She was so nice, you know, really cool. I got there as soon as my friend Ray told me that she just came back from lunch, so I was lucky. So I went over there, I talked to her really quick, I gave her my my drawing, she loved it, and that made me really happy, you know. So yeah, I talked to her really quick. I didn't want to stay too long because I left my table by itself, you know, and it's okay, you know. I had a nice, we did a couple selfies and took a picture with her as well. Just tagged her on her Instagram as well, so I'm very happy, you know. So yeah, that was a good opportunity, you know. So yeah, you know, it was a cool moment. It's like my early birthday gift right now. My birthday is next weekend, so Yeah, so I'm pretty happy right now, you know. Other than that, the show is still super slow. I mean, there's people walking right now, but it's so slow as far as sale. Like, I'm not even worried anymore. Like I said earlier, I'm not expecting a lot, but we'll see what happens. You know, there might always be last minute sale as always, so we'll see. So yeah, you know, I haven't even made any sale yet. Oh dear. It's almost 2 o'clock. Jeez, it's crazy. It's whatever, you know. I'm not happy about the sale, but I'm happy about what I just, you know, got. So yeah. But other than that, you know, as soon as the show is over, I'm gonna hit the road, get some food somewhere, and hit the road. I got an appointment tomorrow at 8 in the morning. I gotta make, so it's gonna be 10 hours drive right now. So yeah, I'm gonna have to be on that caffeine later.
Oh my gosh.
Anyway, I'll talk to you guys later.
It's about, I know I would have had that.
Almost 3 o'clock, it's about 3 o'clock. And it's so dead. I sold a couple prints, but it's like nothing. Like $40. And so I'm very disappointed right now on the last day. It's okay. I think, like I said, anime convention is definitely where I get the best, you know, the show. So I'm gonna try to do more anime convention. So, but yeah, I mean, I'll do comic convention again, you know, if it's a big one. But as of right now, I think anime convention is the way to go for me. It's been so slow right now. It's so dead. And I don't know. I'm trying to think about it. I had all the stuff I thought about earlier. I can think of right now. I realized I haven't talked about the show actually. Yeah. So the show, when you get here, they always do a setup the day before the show, and it's usually from 1 to 7. You know, which is good. This location is nice. The hotel is really, really nice. When you come to this location in St. Louis, you might get confused at when you first arrive, because if you stop in the front, it's a different, it's like the ballroom area. So what you want to do is you want to go around the building, and the back you'll go down behind the hotel, and that's the whole convention area right there. So they have a loading dock in the back, and so you know, it's pretty nice. They give you plenty of time to set up, and everything is always secure at night, so I don't have to worry about anything. I like the people who works here, you know, the staffs. They're pretty great. So I will recommend them, you know, if you guys are interested. I recommend the show. I mean, there's a lot of people. I don't think it has anything to do with where I was located. I thought it was pretty good, you know. But it's just, I don't know, I'm not making any sale, you know, so it's just, you know, just people come here for comic, you know. So, I mean, I saw a lot of, like, cosplayer, you know, for My Hero Academia, but mainly it's kids, you know. Hello there, guys, how you doing? So, like I was saying earlier, they have a loading dock here, you know, as most convention, you know. Setup hours is from 1 to 7. They're very... very cool here, you know, they're very helpful, you know. So yeah, I recommend them, you know, but as far as for me, I don't know if I come back to this show. It's just a long drive. It's like a 10-hour drive, and you know, plus or minus, you know, stop, you know, if I go faster, I don't know. But yeah, you know, so it's a 10-hour drive, and I got a lot of stuff to worry about, the cost of the table, gas, food, and all that. Hotel, you know, Airbnb, whatever, you know, I have whatever I pick, you know. So yeah, you know, so I'm still in the hole right now, you know. I haven't made anything back, so yeah, so I don't know if I'll do this one again. But I heard good things about the St. Louis Anime Convention, so I might try to do that one. We'll see. But if I do come back here, I might have to readjust my price, you know. See what, how it goes, you know. But hello there, how you doing? Yeah, I'm gonna have to do that anyway. Yeah, some of them are sold out already. Yeah. was thinking about readjusting my price. Do a different deal, you know, 1 foot 20, 2 foot 30, and 4 for 40, you know. That way, the first one, if that's the only one they want, is $20. And if they get a second one, you know, they get it for 10. And then instead of having a deal for 3, I do a deal for 4, where if they get 4, it's just $40 right away. So, you know, we'll see how that goes. I was talking to the guys that I met yesterday, and that's basically the deal that they were doing, which is pretty interesting. So I might start doing that. Yeah, make sure when you guys have, make sure you guys have good deals, you know, when you guys do convention. It definitely help on sales, you know, and let them know, you know. If they don't see the sign, tell them, hey, you know, this is what I do. One is for 20, you get the second one for $10, and then you get two more for $40 only. And usually people, when they look at the, if they have cash only, they just look at the money, you know, and they don't like getting changed, right? So it kind of forces them to like get a couple extra prints. So yeah, it's a good, you know, it's a good idea. I might start doing that. So probably at the next show, I will. So yeah, I think that's about it. They serve food around here, you know, very pricey, but that's the hotel stuff. So yeah, I don't recommend that. And they're kind of stingy. I ordered some Chinese food from the hotel yesterday, and it was like $9 for a 1 pound box only, and they didn't even fill that up all the way. It was like halfway. Hello there, how you doing? So it was a waste. So I don't recommend getting the food here. It was pretty overpriced. Other than that, I don't know. There's always a lot of cool artists here. Very friendly. So I mean, for the connection, I guess, you know, try it. Definitely if you're in the area, try it. Otherwise, if you're too far, I wouldn't recommend it. Another thing again, you know, the advertisement, people has been telling me about it, is they don't really advertise it well, you know. You need to do a better job at advertising it. Like all the artists and vendors, they all tell me, yeah, you know, like nobody knows about it, you know. So it's just like a Facebook, you know, ad thing, but it's not enough, you know. They gotta find other ways to advertise. So that's one inconvenience. But otherwise, you know, the tables are pretty affordable. Depending on where they are, as it ranges from 75 to 150. So it's still pretty good, especially if, like, they're pretty big tables, you know. So yeah. Yeah, I think that's it, you know. As far as my live drawing yesterday, I think it worked really well. I had a lot of people that came by and just watched me draw. It was kind of hard to manage stopping and selling at the same time, you know, when people wanted a print. So that's one thing. Then again, it's on me because I come by myself. I come on my own, so that's one inconvenience. But if you guys have someone, you guys should be fine. One person is at a table for prints, and you just keep doing your thing on the canvas, you know. So yeah, it's another thing I gotta work on. I gotta have a partner with me, you know. And see what else. I don't know if the sticker things work for me. I might have to discontinue that, depending on how it works in the next shows. I know it works well at anime convention, so I don't know, we'll see. It might just be something I keep for anime convention. But right here, stickers doesn't work, you know, so yeah. I just ran out of my postcards, so I need to make a few more and see how that goes. It took me a while. I printed that last year, and I just finally ran out of it, so I might not print as much this time, you know, maybe just 5 each only. So that's it, you know. I gotta keep working on new projects. I feel like, even though I haven't really been twice in the same city yet, I feel like I need new print. I feel like I don't have anything flashy or anything in the mainstream right now, you know, so yeah. I mean, I figure out. I got a big DC project that I gotta finish, so hopefully it won't take me too long. But then again, you know, as you have seen on my last video, where I talk about, like, I reflect on what I've done so far. You know, I told myself I take it easy, so I'm not gonna rush on that project. just because, you know, my daughter is being, my daughter is getting, you know, she's growing up. She's four, and I need to spend more time with her. I'm teaching her how to ride a bike right now. So during the week, when I come back from work, you know, we usually go ride at the lake and, you know, spend time with her, do more things like that, you know. So, yes, I'm not going to stress too much about it. You know, I get the project done when I get it done. And end of the day, I take commissions if I can. I just won't take big project anymore. So, yeah, I think that's what I'm going to be doing for the rest of the year. See how that goes. Hello there, guys. Feel free to look. Let me know if you guys have any question, all right? Yeah. I drew that live yesterday. Were you guys here yesterday?
No.
Oh, I was drawing it live. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Well, let me know if you have any questions. Right now, I do everything is 10, and I do a buy two, get one free, so.
All right.
Yeah. I know, it ran out.
I love this stuff.
I've got a pen, but yeah.
Students.
Yes, exactly. Parents.
Go for it. Yeah.
So cool.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. They go by real fast, so it's so hard. Thank you.
I've got a pocket full.
Yeah.
I'll be busy one day just looking at everything online.
Right. Thank you. Yeah. What else was I talking about? Yeah, so I'm taking it easy on the big project. I take my time now on doing what I do. So, I didn't get picked for Yomacon, so that's too bad. I won't be there. I was really hoping, but then, you know, it's a jury and lottery, you know, pick, you know, which is, I don't know, I guess it's cool, but kind of sucks also, because I feel like when people do that, they get a lot of the same artists, you know, every year, which is cool, I guess, you know, but... You know, like some of the shows that do that, they always get their friends, you know. And from what I heard from other artists, you know, it kind of sucks. Like some people have been applying for like 4 years in the same show, and they never get picked. But when they go as an attendee, it's always the same artists. It's like they're all buddies, you know. So I don't know. Hopefully that's not the case for you, Macon. But that kind of sucks, you know. That's why I like the first come first serve, you know, basis. And yeah. Because you never know, there's always a factor of which guests they bring, which celebrities, and so, you know, not everyone brings anyway, so that's one thing. But yeah, so I didn't make it to YomaCon, I didn't make it to Anime Fusion, so now I two of the convention I had on my schedule that I was hoping to get, I just have that slot off now, you know, I'm in free now, so I'm gonna try to see if I can do... can find another show in last minute, probably gonna be a small one, but if I can find one, I'll do it. If not, then it's fine. It gives me more time to work on the other convention, other project, I mean. So yeah, other than that, I think for the years it's pretty much set. If I can find anything else, whatever is on my schedule is whatever I have left for shows, which is fine with me. I learned about a couple of new shows for next year that I'm going to look into, that some artists around here told me about, so I'll look into that. And I don't know what else to say. It's been so slow here today. Show the people, the staff here is good once again, so definitely recommend it. Like I said, I might not be here next year. We'll see how it goes. But yeah, that's about it, you know. Oh, what I like here is they have a security guy walking around all the time, so you always see them. I haven't seen that at the other convention yet, so here that's what they do. That's per the hotel, so that's pretty cool. So I like that. That's it. Can't think of anything else to say. So I'll see you guys in a bit, probably when I pack up. See you guys. All right, take 12. So a lot of people are starting to pack up already. It's like it's 4:35. We have like 25 minutes. But yeah, you know, it's so slow right now. It's so dead. So I'm gonna start packing up too. There's nothing else going on. Basically, everybody's gone. I just see the same people walking around, having a hard time deciding what they're gonna get. But yeah, that's about it. I'm gonna pack up because I got a long way to go for home. And yeah, that's it. All I did basically the last 3 hours is just go around and, you know, well, not around, just like on my neighbor's table, just so I have to view my table. And all I did is just, you know, do some art trade with them, that's it, you know. And every time I looked at my table, there's like nobody, so, you know, I don't know. It's kind of dead. Yeah, that's it. I'm gonna say goodbye to the guys, you know, after this, and that's it. And so, yeah, this show is probably not gonna have a long vlog, so anyway, I'll see you guys later.
It's super simple, okay?